Smart relays are the base for most DIY home automation. In this episode, we're gonna have a look at the Sonoff ZBmini and the Aqara T1. Since my smart network is based mostly on Zigbee communication, I had to look around for Zigbee relays. We're gonna have a look at the most commonly used relays, the Sonoff ZBmini and the Aqara T1. Let's start with the Sonoff ZBmini. Inside we're gonna find the relay and an instruction manual. The relay itself is very small. For both versions, I chose the ones which work with a null connection. That means that the router capability of both relays will be enabled. So we have the Sonoff ZBmini, and now let's open the Aqara T1. The Aqara T1 comes in a way bigger package. Once we open it up, we have a really nice manual. The relay itself, and an empty box. Let's put this aside. These relays are supposed to be mounted usually behind dumb switches or plugs. Let me show you what I mean. I have here a classic connector. It's a dual channel one. The idea is that you're gonna take one of these relays, mount it inside the plug, yeah, behind the plug actually, and you can turn this one into, I don't know, a smart device, right? As dimensions, they're kindly the same. Around 4.2, 4.3 centimeters wide. There's not such a big difference between the two of them. The only big noticeable difference is that the Aqara T1 has an external antenna that should allow you to have, I don't know, probably a better range of signal. I didn't test this out, so I can't confirm that this antenna actually does anything extra. Which one you should get then? Well, even if they look similar, there is a big major difference between them in terms of functionality. The Sonoff ZBmini is intended, as we spoke before, to be mounted behind the switch so you can make it smart, and also has the router capability that will extend your Zigbee network inside your house. What's extra with this Aqara T1 is that besides doing all that, it also has an important feature. Power meter. This relay can be mounted behind the switch or the plug, same as with at the Sonoff, but as an additional feature, it will be able to measure the power consumed by the device connected. So even if they look the same, their functionality is pretty different. Since a requirement for me, it was that both devices will need to have a router capability in order to extend my network, I only had the options to buy the devices with the null connections. By standard, from what I've seen, all the devices that do not require the null wire will not have that router capability available. I'm gonna install the Sonoff ZBmini inside the junction box in my house just to extend the Zigbee network. I'm not gonna use any external switch, so I'm not gonna connect any external contact for this unit. It will simply work as a router. The Aqara T1 instead will be installed behind the power socket, and that way I can use the power meter function of it to monitor the power consumption of my office desk. So make sure that you buy the proper one for your needs. I'm gonna come back with later videos showing how to install both the Aqara T1, the Sonoff ZBmini, and also how to integrate them into Home Assistant. If you enjoyed this short video, please don't forget to like and subscribe.